scared of. And I tricked you once again.
I went down on the hay and I seen all these young kids.
As soon as Charlie demonstrated his singing and songwriting skills, the surfer boy was immediately intrigued and promised to record a demo for him and release his music on the Beach Boy record label, Brother Records.
And I went over and Ray Lee told me, he says, man, you can't do anything with that. He said, they're out there playing rock and roll.
If I can make myself nervous, I should be able to make myself
nervous. Hi, Charlie, baby!
Dennis brought Charlie and some of the girls to Brian's house to record a demo. And sitting behind the control booth was Terry Melcher, son of Doris Day and successful record producer of such artists as The Byrds and Paul Revere and the Raiders.
Let's see.
Do whatever you feel like, man.
Yeah.
Just groove, you know? Tell us when you want to start and we'll turn the machine on.
Okay. Well, I woke up this morning and grabbed my shoes. Way I run to get the news. I looked in the paper, first thing I saw, my baby bent down to see the law. She done.
Do you remember a guy called Steve Desper? He engineered some of the sessions at Brian's house. And he said the big problem with Manson was that there was simply no way that Manson would let himself be produced.
Yeah, I mean, don't rush.
Yeah. You know, it's hard to sing in the microphones. I don't feel nothing for these microphones. Giant phallic symbol pointing at you. All my latent tendencies are just...
Forget we're even here, man. What are you nervous about? Just blow your soul,
hey,
man.
Well, look here, let me explain something to you. I just have to groove on it for a while, get used to it, man, you know.
You're into something good.
Oh, yeah.
It's all in the eyes of a dream.
I mean, Charlie could sit down with the guitar and just ad lib. I mean, it's almost now you could equate it with rap, but then, I mean, he could just make up a song just plunking out a couple of chords.
He was able to organize his thoughts to a point where they were hypnotic, but yet entertaining, meaningful, and spiritual too.
Well, Dennis and he got along okay, but when it got to a creative thing, if Dennis was producing and Charlie was the artist, then any suggestions that Dennis had to make should have been at least considered by Charles in those roles. But Charlie was not going to be produced. He wasn't. He had no idea of what recording sessions were about, how to make records, how to deal with people that way. He took it all very personally, and he was not a professional artist.
What also troubled the studio engineer was how Manson's true personality would surface. As he once recalled, Charlie waving around a buck knife in a stoned frenzy.
Of course, nobody knew anything about Charles Manson at that time, except that he was more or less a street musician, and there certainly were a lot of those.
Over time, Charlie got the idea that Melcher was to produce his songs, but more importantly, spread his wise words to the masses.
Terry Melcher came to me. I didn't come to Terry Melcher. He came to me with money in his hand. He offered me. I didn't ask him. I wasn't knocking someone's door down. I was running from that. When I got out, I was in that. I was already through that. I had that. I had the studio. I went to the studio. I went to Vox Studios. I had it all. And I looked at it, and I said, this is a bigger jail than I just got out of.
My brother Dennis was in pretty bad shape. He had a problem with drugs and alcohol. And it wouldn't go away.
Wilson, recently divorced from his first wife, Carol Friedman, with whom he had a daughter with, Jennifer, and whose son, Scott, he had adopted. Dennis did have joint custody over the children, but was often away touring with the band or caught up in some sort of drug binge.
I'm Dennis Wilson and Keith Moon. We're like you know, what rock and roll legendary crap is all about.
He was a rebel. He rebelled against the authority and the abusiveness of Murray, the mixed messages he was always getting as a child, and he continued to rebel.
My brother, and he's my brother. Dennis Wilson, it's here.
I mean, we had to kick him out of the group a couple, three times for him to go sober up enough so that he could play the drums.
And his brothers basically said, you know, you're bound by contract, and if you renege, we're going to have you committed. You know, we're going to get psychiatric testimony that you've flipped your lid, and so you know, you're a slave to this contract, however many years he was bound.
Had he been able to maintain his personal equilibrium, I think he would have been a major recording star in his own right.
Dennis, enamored with Charlie, bragged about his friendship in an issue of the English rock magazine, Rave. "Fear is nothing but awareness," spoke Dennis, mimicking Manson's guru-driven mumbo-jumbo. "Sometimes the wizard frightens me. Charlie Manson, who says he is God and the devil. He sings, plays, and writes poetry."
Hey, thanks. The boys and I'd like to thank you. And matter of fact, we're gonna join you.
I think the business of the family was a really tough issue. You know, it's kind of like, we're not in Kansas anymore.
It was as if he wasn't going to have to be responsible for the consequences of his actions, of the way he lived.
At one point, he had put a knife to Dennis's throat, and he said, it'd be so easy to cut your throat. And Dennis said to him, go ahead.
It really scared me. I was, you know, I thought, oh my God, something someday is going to really happen to Dennis, and he won't be here.